So, the accompaniment to the E minor scale. Now, the interesting and the problematic bit about this accompaniment is that I have not one first or third beat. So every single time you have to start a note, I'm not playing. So you have to make the decision to play. You have to count, listen to the metronome and know when to play. Don't wait to me. So basically the way it goes is like, we'll do it very slow. I'll show you the first couple of bars. So one, two, three, four, one, three, four, one, two, three. So I never ever actually play on the one or the three, but those are the beats that you have to play. So this is a real challenge for you to take the initiative, yeah, to be confident that you know what you're doing. If you wait until I play, you're a quaver late, an eighth note late, yeah. So don't. You have to be confident, you have to have this practiced well enough that you go like one, so basically one, two, three, four, one, two. Irrelevant of whether I'm playing or not, you have to go for it, yeah. It's destabilizing. In the beginning it's going to be confusing, but the more you practice, the more you'll understand how things fit together, yeah? This time, you're the soloist and I'm accompanying you, yeah? So, anyway, we're going to start really slower at 40. The finger pattern, I hope you've practiced it already with the other video, but in case you haven't. On the way up, it is a minor key, so it's different on the way up than the way down. On the way up, 2 and 3 are against each other on the D string. 3 and 4 are against each other on the A string because you have C sharp and D sharp added to the scale, yeah? And on the E string, it's 1 and 2 against each other. And the way down, it's the same finger pattern as the G major scale because the notes are identical, so on the highest two strings you have 1 and 2 against each other, so nothing changes with the E string. And on the D string, you have 2 and 3 against each other, which is exactly the same as it was on the way up as well. Yeah, so the only changes here are on the A string. On the way up it's 3, 4, on the way down it's 1 and 2 that are against each other. Now, we're going to play. We're at 40.
Thank you.
So that's it. It's a bit unstable with me never playing the heavy beats, the first and the third. But try to fit things together and you'll find out soon enough that it's kind of fun to be able to take the lead. You're the lead now. I know I can't adjust my recording to whatever you're doing, but if you know your scale well enough, it shouldn't be no problem for you to stick with the metronome and to lead anyway. Okay? Good luck, and we'll do this at 60 and 80 and so on. Yeah? See you there.